First Corinthians 11:24-25. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. In the same way, he took the cup and blessed it and said, this is the cup of the new covenant between God and you, sealed by the shedding of my blood. Do this in remembrance of me as often as you drink it. What did Jesus mean when he said, do this in remembrance of me? In a way, it seems to be unnecessary for him to have said it. It's impossible to imagine that somehow we could have communion, Lord's Supper, and not remember that Jesus is associated with it, the reason of it. And how can we partake of the juice and the bread and not remember of Jesus' sacrifice of his body and his blood? So, that we are to, quote, do this in remembrance of me, is obviously very important to Jesus. And he said it twice. Once in association with his blood, and once in association with his blood, the sacrifice of his body. Well, did he think that he'd forget how he was mocked and tortured by the Romans? Or that we would not remember that he voluntarily died an agonizing sacrificial death on the cross? Do you think that maybe we would forget that he was dead and sealed in a tomb, that neither tomb nor death could hold him, and that he was resurrected as the Savior of the world? What do you think he was telling us to instruct us to remember? And I think that the reason might be that Jesus didn't want us to just remember what happened at the end of his life. He wanted to remember me, remember all of me, remember all of that God. There are 24 chapters in the book of Luke. Jesus' arrest occurs towards the end of the 22nd chapter. So in Luke's book about the life of Jesus, about 1/10 of it tells of Jesus' arrest, death, and resurrection. Jesus did not want us to forget about the other 90% of the story. He not to just die for us. He also came to teach us how God wanted us to live. He wanted us to remember that we are to love God with all our heart, all our strength, and all our might. That we are to love others as ourselves. Nobody is unwanted or unlovable or should be looked down upon. We should not think of ourselves as better than others because we are all equal, equal sinners. New salvation. We'll be humble. Help those in need. If you're fools to reject God's the way God wants us to live in order to pursue the empty promises of Satan and the pleasures of this world. We are to be generous, be quick to forgive and slow to anger. We remember that when Jesus was baptized, God spoke from heaven, saying, this is my Son, in whom I am well pleased.